I went out and I harvested greatness almighty.
Hallelujah.
That is what we are trying to legalize next November 5th. We're going to have the show here. We're going to rally the faithful, and then we are going to vote for the second time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is blessed everyone. So as I was going through the natives to harvest the invasive, which is medical marijuana, I was attacked by wasps.
Oh, I hate those fucking things.
And that, I am almost positive, was karma for harvesting and laboring on Labor Day.
That makes sense.
Those wasps were in solidarity with the union movement. Hallelujah. Not only is the union movement responsible for middle class protest songs, but also for the medical marijuana and recreational marijuana movement. Hallelujah. If it wasn't for the labor movement, we wouldn't have had rock and roll protest songs.
Yeah.
And if we didn't have Woodstock rock and roll protest songs, and the civil rights movement, and democracy, we wouldn't have had the medical marijuana, recreational marijuana movement. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Movement.
So those killer wasps had the right idea. Thank you.
Yes.
I got stung on my hand.
Good.
And on my elbow. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You deserved it, Reverend. You deserved it.
That's right. Hallelujah. So I stopped and I desisted. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I went home and I recreated like I should. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Any other special prayers?
Madonna.
Hallelujah.
She needs help.
What's wrong with Madonna?
I haven't seen her.
Oh, okay. Hallelujah.
Just pray that she lives for at least 120 years.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Woo!
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Okay. How about special prayers to the Messiah?
Oh, I can't help you guys.
Hallelujah.
Surfer Jesus.
Test or cheat on a lie detector test, I really can't help you with anything.
Sir, as a Muslim woman, I can tell you, hallelujah, I guess.
Hallelujah.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Anyway, Server Jesus is here basically to, this is an interim coming.
It is
not the second coming, yes. This is not the apocalypse. He's not, he's just coming here to keep us faithful.
Hallelujah.
And save our souls from whatever. Any other special prayers? Britney Spears.
Yeah.
Woo!
She needs help.
Hallelujah.
She needs to clean her eyes. Clean her eyes. She needs to do
eye
contouring and
yes, please.
Some moisturizing under the eyes.
All right.
Yes, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank God and Jesus for it.
All right. Also, we are praying for... We're just praying for everybody, that they live peaceful, productive lives. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. This is the greatest show we've ever done tonight.
Thank you. Our mother,
who
growest, the greatest dream, up there in the Ojambosphere,
under the influence
of the domestic, they trim up there, in replete nudity, not luidity, bearing their souls for posterity. Thank you, Officer Friendly. Aren't you supposed to be taking a day off? This is Labor Day. I love seeing you. But I really am thinking that your family needs you more. Search my car if you need something to do. And if she finds anything suspicious. No idea how it got there. Jesus must have put it there. He is the Messiah. That's why he left the room.
The rum, all the rum.
And I will swear to this in a court of law, I will be vindicated, adjudicated, and best of all, Baker Acton. Which means more drugs. The wine is the cowboy, the rain and the shroom, amen. A woman, a joint, another. God has blessed them all. Hallelujah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Cloud. Of course he's outside smoking doobies. That's the way we roll here at the Tabernacle of Eden. If you're in the room when I call you, you fucked up and you'll never be called again. Cloud! Where's Cloud? Is he coming? There he is! He's bringing a guitar. Cloud, everybody! What a star. What a rock star. Those fucking glasses. Holy shit. All right, we'll play some interim music and then we'll Cloud out.
Thank you. It's just sitting
there. Retard shirt all the way up.
Hey.
But I would be surprised. Wouldn't be attracted to something. But like when you were high.
Hey guys! Oh, my shoe's untied. That's okay. Hopefully, I won't trip on that. So actually, I finished writing a new song last night, so... this makes me my age. Thanks. So, yeah, this one's called Wilt. Yeah. Thanks. Rocking everybody's balls in the house. Let's do it.
Balls rolled off on that one.
The absolute honor.
I went bowling on that shit.
Wow. This is what it feels like to go first at the Tabernacle. I'm amazed. Like, what's that? Like, that feels like my first. Yeah, it's like that crap. Yeah, literally. My brain just conjures beams, but okay. I got another song. Also, real quick, I'm throwing a block party September 13th, Friday the 13th. So come talk to me. I'll send you the flyer. I'll send you the info.
Where do we park?
It's downtown. So there's
parking in Bassiners to help us do your block party.
There is plenty of parking in the vicinity. Luckily, actually, I have this like perfect spot. So. Anyways, come talk to me about details. Friday the 13th, up in the atmosphere, a bunch of punk bands, and my band, Issue of Destiny, as well. So come check it out. I got another song. This is called Decay. saw, come check out the band and come check out the show.
Woo!
So cool. Oh, your larynx fell out. Sick, that was it. Give a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Now we're moving along. The show is going very well. I don't know who's arrived or who's left. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our favorite performer and serial killer songs, the one and only Tapeworm! Surfer Jesus has left. We did not have the benefit of his comedy tonight. He's dealing with a lot of shit. He will always have your back. Jesus will always have your back. Let's have his. Let's give some great thoughts to Surfer Jesus, and we hope to have him back soon to do comedy. We love you, Surfer Jesus. We love you so much. We're putting this on the internet with the Reverend Angel Dust fancy, newfangled iPad. Amazing, amazing discovery. The iPad is very useful. All of you can use it. Excuse me while I attend to this message. Surfer Jesus will be opening for Brian Posehn, a very famous comedian at the Woolly. Keep an eye out on your book of face. Is that cool? We love Surfer Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hey, we weren't expecting anybody. Anybody has to leave, we're not going to miss you. We thought there'd be like four people. We were going to have a drinking party, and now it's a big fucking brigade of people. So we're very excited. We think songs about serial killers is just what you need right about now. And anything else Tapeworm wants to do. Tapeworm is now officially a deacon of the Tabernacle of Hebrews. He has an official deacon card. Jason made deacon cards and we awarded them last week. I even have a deacon card somewhere. There it is. And go into any Starbucks and tell those people, I'm not gonna say your fucking sizes the way you want me to. I'm gonna say, I want a little cup of coffee, and if you try to throw some Venti shit on me or whatever that other shit is, I'm gonna fucking ruin your store.
Thank you.
I'll wreck your store. You'll never serve phony Italian coffee in this town again. I have anything to say about it.
Yeah. Fuck Starbucks.
Yeah. Fucking Starbucks. You know, seriously.
Starbucks sucks.
They used to be all about free trade and all that shit. They've never been to these places. They don't even know what real coffee tastes like. I tell you right now, it doesn't taste anything like what they're making at Starbucks. Excuse me if I go on a rant here. What the fuck is going on with that food? It's all various forms of the same mug. They just press it into the cheese Danish. They press it into the cat fucking whatever that thing is, the cat lollipop. What the fuck are they doing? What kind of insanity is going on at Starbucks? Is it healthy? No. Is it really free trade? No. Fuck Starbucks! Fuck them! Jeez! What the fuck? No, I'm not buying the bullshit anymore. Ladies and gentlemen, Tapeworm, give him a round of applause.
There was a campaign. You know, it said Starbucks coffee. So there was a campaign with black markers to just make it say fuck off.
It was pretty easy. I wouldn't know, but anyway, they fucking fired their workers who walked out in solidarity with the Palestinians. They were on strike, so they fired them. So yeah, just one more reason to hate Starbucks. Anyway, plugged in and everybody. Arthur of Blueberry Season told me about this Tabernacle of Hedonism. He said it's the punk rock open mic. Say no more, I'm going to it. He didn't say anything about it being a cult, but here I am. It's too late now. So Nathan Tenney's death day today. He was 5 months old when he was killed by his mother 49 years ago today. This is about his mother. Mary Beth Tenney, children had no luck at survival. Joseph Jr. at age 2, pronounced dead on arrival. Barbara Timothy, the Nathan child after child. How many dead babies, how could the truth be so vile? Sudden infant death syndrome, and this time was in style. Mary Beth enjoyed the sympathy, it made her smile. She stacked bouquets of flowers and presents in one big pile. Told Timmy when it's nap time again, and this nap would be final. Don Hagawa's death day today, day before yesterday, 128 years ago. Eli Parker was his English name. Don Hagawa went to missionary school where he was taught to read and write. He studied law to be a lawyer, so he thought he'd change his name to Eli Parker. So he appeared as worded, talk a well-like manner, admitted to the bar, and he entered not. Finally, he felt the need to help his people work like hell to get the job commissioner. He fit the slot. All the work changed him a lot. In D.C., his enemies were many and could not be stopped. At his death, he learned to hate the way things were done at the top. That is the person by the soul, their side of soul, and by that cold January of Montana, they set out for a job. Black and black, he kept was caught off guard to be wicked in the truck. On that bloody daughter of 200 were killed on the spot. Peaceful black, he kept was caught off guard, awakened to be shot. On that bloody day, around 200 were killed on the spot. In the bigger picture in the book, and this was just one drop. Karen Hill's death day today. She was killed by the Genesee River Killer 52 years ago today. I play this one a lot, but it's, I didn't even write the music. It's a Bob Dylan. Fires were set, he wet the bed, he got molested by his mom. He practiced bestiality on chickens and sheep, which is the wrong draft. They taught him to kill and shipped him off to Vietnam. And if not already fucked off, a shock rock was completely fucking gone. Gone. He killed some children. Keep it short and go straight to the cover song. Now, it's John S. Hall's birthday today. One of the first conversations I ever had with you, Tom, I sent your poem about the fish that died. Intern? Yeah, I said it reminded me of King Missile. And you said that you you wrote letters. You like corresponded with King Missile and John S. Hall. He turned 64 years old today. Came out, I was on the top 10 for months. Detachable penis. But I'm gonna play What If. One day, what if one day, what if I said I wish I was a tree, and then suddenly I was a tree, and then I wish myself back. No, trees can't wish. What if I wished I was a wish? Thank you. a couple songs up, so I got to do the firecracker. Also, yeah, go to the block party. Woo! Grabback's gonna be there, Fueling Buttons will be there, who else?
Violent Affection, Tainted Soil.
Issue of Destiny. Tainted Soil, I like the sound of that. Alright.
Angry Cowboy Metal.
What?
It's Angry Cowboy Metal. You'll love it.
Alright, Angry
Cowboy. Ooh, Porch Metal.
So I have to apologize. I think I might have pissed off our clowns. When I was promoting the show today, I said, no mimes. I've said this many, many times. It's just for fun. It's fun to exclude a group of people to come to the show. Sometimes it's no magicians, no monkey handlers, no mimes. But what happened was, I think because our clowns dress up and they look like mimes, they got very upset. So they caused a big problem, and I said, well, Tom, the mime from SeaWorld, can come. And then I think they took that doubly offensive, and then now I don't know if they're ever going to come here again.
That's mimesist.
So I'm not really sure. I'm not a mimesist. I'm not a mimesist. You know what I mean? Everybody is welcome here at the Tabernacle of Hedonism, except for bullshit mimes. I don't want to see any more fucking mimes caught in a goddamn box. We've had that already. Develop your craft, alright? If your act is you're stuck in a fucking box, you're stuck in a fucking box! Don't come here, get out of the box and do better mimes. Mime a banana. You know, mime AI. Do some fucking, you know, push the envelope here, alright? We're not here doing like the old tired shit from history. We're trying to evolve. We're trying to progress. Folks, if we don't progress in our craft, we are never going to make it to Doobytopia. We are never going to enjoy the reverence of the space mammals. We're never going to understand why it is that the alien motherhood is reverse engineering UFOs in the independent Florida alligator, even after we told them to stop doing that. Don't you understand? These mimes are fucking us up! I won't tolerate it. I just won't tolerate it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for my public service message, and please welcome to the stage, Jason. Give him a round of applause. One of the leaders of a church, I have important shit I have to do, okay? Don't come up here to play your songs and just get on my ass because I gotta do my shit. Alright, this is a religious institution. And also, we love you. Thank you for being here.
I'll fix that.
Yeah,
that's
the
Check.
I'm gonna end up grabbing that boom mic too when I sit down. You told me to do four, so I'm gonna. It's well on. It's just the gain's really fucking hot on it. Yeah, that's. Check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Check.
No, we definitely need more guitar.
Check. All right.
Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, Jason.
All right. So I'm gonna do two spoken word pieces: a guitar song and a hurdy-gurdy song. I'm also gonna tell a quick joke I wrote today. So the joke is, So the joke is, good sex is like an episode of Whose Line Is It Anyway? Everything's made up and the points don't matter. Anyway, so now I'm going to say the words that nobody wants to hear at open mic night. I'm going to read some original erotic fantasy. This is called Pizza Boy. I wrote this a while ago, but it's really fun. I really enjoy it. So, I saw you in a dream once. I was on my knees and you held my face with both hands and kissed me gently, your lips soft against mine. The smell of whiskey and sweat and clove cigarettes. I lean into you for a deeper kiss, but you pull back, teasing me, and I fall forward. The restraints are strong, though. My arms are stretched tight, further cuffed behind my back, and I'm leaning, straining against the pain in my shoulders. And you laugh, watching me hang there. I didn't give you permission to kiss me, you say, as your open hand meets my right cheek. I try to mutter an apology, but I'm interrupted by your other hand on the other cheek. You grab my hair, pull me upright again, barely giving me time to get my balance before you press your manhood deep into my throat. Eyes watering, choking, saliva pouring out of the glands of my mouth and running down my neck. It's getting hard to breathe. Even if I wanted to use a safe word, I don't think I could. I can see stars now, skin red, veins bulging just as I start to wonder when it'll be over. Your rhythm slows, fingernails dig into my scalp, your flesh swells, and your gift floods my mouth, hot and sticky and more than I was expecting. I barely manage to swallow, it's not on my face, and breathless as you utter a, "Thank you, sir." Suddenly your hand wraps around my throat, slamming me against the wall, and you kiss me deeply, almost tenderly, as you reach behind me to undo the cuffs. When you let go of my throat, I slump to the floor on hands and knees, shoulders burning, gasping for breath. I gaze up in your eyes and see a wry smile cross your lips just before you spit in my face. "You fucking faggot!" You scream and kick me to the floor. As you reach for the cat of nine tails, you remind me that you bought some Ben and Jerry's ice cream and they'll be waiting for us when we're done. You also promise to order a pizza. Pepperoni and mushroom with a side of garlic butter dipped the crust in. It's my favorite. I've never been happier. One more. This one's less graphic. Less graphic, more philosophical. But this is an imagining of a non-binary threesome. So it's called Gender Isn't Real. Warm mouths and hot flesh, squeeze hard and pressed, wet and sublime. I can still smell you. Weed and wine, your breath. I need another goddamn cigarette. Blowing my mind, I can still taste you. Who's the man? Doesn't matter. Sweat and KY, slimy slather. Pushing hard inside, I can still feel you. We three join together as one, free at last as we come undone. Who's next to ride? I can still teach you. Hands that grasp and grope. Teeth and leather grab a rope, fit to be tied. I can still please you. Wild creatures unrestrained, all the pleasures, all the pain. What else can we try? I can still feed you. Undefined nebulous roles, maybe the cow, maybe the bull. In here there's no lies, I can still seek truth. Gender isn't fucking real. We're all just gay men here. This girl doesn't hide. I can still be you. Feels good to be a faggot. Alright. So I'm gonna sing a song now. So I was trying to write another like fantasy thing. I was like, what if like Mickey and Mallory and Bonnie and Clyde were like werewolves? And like this couple was having this like fantasy about doing crazy shit, like murder shit. And so I wrote this song with a sort of like little fantasy idea in mind. And then when I finished the song and performed it for the first time, I was thinking about it. I'm like, wait, fuck, this song's about furries. Quite unintentionally, this is a song about furries having a weird, like, sexual murder fantasy. and drawing it all out in cartoons, because that's what furries do, right? I'm not a furry, but I'm definitely furry friendly. It's called Blue Moon.
Down by the old drag, watching the moon rise. I can see the sunset shining in your eyes. Fresh blood dripping along with your knife. A werewolf wearing a well-worn disguise. Which one of us is perfect victim? Try to tell your secrets, which are at the victim. The house is on fire and the doors have been kicked in. Going together and we're riding in safety.
Yeah. bartender, ladies and gentlemen.
Enjoying the show, great. If you're not enjoying the show, check in with Daryl and get a couple drinks and adjust the show accordingly. Remember, the more you drink, the better the show appears to be.
Power bottom.